Om Shanti, 15th April 2020. In today's Bab Dada's Murli, Bab Dada has drawn our attention to the fact that this is the most valuable diamond birth of you children. So you need to be very much cautious about the pilgrimage of remembrance, because Baba is absolutely in mood of praising those children who are constant and who are effort making when it comes to the race of the pilgrimage of remembrance. Baba also says that when somebody suppose gives donation of money, so surely it is the duty of the God to pay him the result or return him the money in his very next birth, but that doesn't mean that the sins of that particular soul is being absolved. It is all about remembrance. He said, now you have become godly children, so there is no point of you fighting or quarreling over trivial matters with one another. There is no point of you being in a condition of quarrel or fight with each other. This is what animals do, Baba quotes. He also said that you need to understand the difference between the power of silence and the power of science. As we all know that for all great inventions, there is this requirement of silence, because silence is basically the sole requirement for any sort of invention or creation. Science can create things which is capable of destroying this world, but silence has the capacity to create an absolutely new world. And Bab Dada is actually creating Satyug with the power of silence and remembrance. And Baba also says that you need to be very cautious when it comes about the pilgrimage of remembrance, because ultimately your sins are going to get absolved by that only. He also said that body consciousness is something that you can see the worst thing that you have. So it is very important to understand that body consciousness is the root cause of your vices, so you definitely should renounce it. He also said that may you have the blessing of the same applies to you. That means the same applies to you. In Hindi we say tattvam, the same applies to you. By bringing time close with your stage of being equal to the Father, this is the only opportunity, this is the sole opportunity in the entire world cycle when we children are capable enough to have a stage equivalent to the Godfather, that is Shiv Baba. Baba said that there should not be any percent of defect when it comes to of you being attached to any materialistic item or to any individual or people. Baba says, in case only when you give regard to one another's ideas, then you will record, then your particular record of good karmic account or divine virtues will become good, only when you pay regard to others. Now listen to the Murli in detail. So in today's Murli, Bab Dada says, sweet children, your present time is your most valuable birth, and it is in this birth that you have to make effort so that you can become pure and become deities from ordinary human beings. Question is, what main virtue do those who call themselves the children of God imbibe? So Bab Dada says that they live with each other like milk and sugar, totally dissolved and sweet in taste, and they never become like salt water. Body conscious human beings talk about wrong things and continue to fight and quarrel. Your children must not have such habits, and here you have to imbibe divine virtues and reach your karmatit stage. Om Shanti. The Father first says to your children that may you be soul conscious and consider yourselves to be souls. No matter what it says in the Gita, etc., all of those scriptures belong to the path of devotion. The Father says, I am the ocean of knowledge. I speak knowledge to your children. And what knowledge do I speak? I speak the knowledge of the beginning, the middle and the end of the world, that is the drama. This is the study of history and geography. Basically, we all need to be firm in the teachings of drama, because then only we'll be able to imbibe the Murli in our lives. Well, Baba says on the path of devotion, no one studies history and geography. They don't even mention it. Sages and holy men sit and study these scriptures. The Father does not study any scriptures before speaking knowledge to you. He makes you into deities from ordinary human beings with this study, and you come here in order to become deities from ordinary humans. You are human beings and they too are human beings. That is, deities are also human beings and you are also human beings. So where is the difference? In divine virtues. Well, people call out to the Godfather that, O purifier, come. You know that deities are pure and that all the rest of the human beings who bow down in front of them are impure. They considered themselves to be impure and the deities pure, but how did the deities become pure? Who made them pure? No human being knows this, therefore the Father explains that consider yourselves to be souls and remember the Father. There is effort in this and do not have body consciousness. Souls are imperishable and sanskars are in each soul. Souls take their good and bad sanskars with them, and this is why the Father says, now be soul conscious. No one knows about his own soul. The path of darkness begins when the kingdom of Ravan begins and everyone becomes body conscious. The Father sits here and explains that you children now know to whom you have come. You haven't come to this one, that is, we don't come to Brahma Baba. Indirectly, Baba is saying, I have entered this one and this is his last impure birth of his many births. And what type of many births? So you have been told that there are pure births for half a cycle and there are impure births for the other half. Therefore, this one is also impure, and Brahma doesn't call himself a deity or god. People believe that Prajapita Brahma was a deity. This is why they say salutations to the deity Brahma. In Hindi, we call it Brahma Devtai Namaha. So Baba says that you are Brahma Kumars and Kumaris. You are Brahmins, and Brahma is also a Brahmin. Who calls him a deity? Brahma is called a Brahmin, not a deity. Even when this Brahma becomes pure, he would still not be called a deity until and unless he becomes Vishnu, which means Lakshmi and Narayan. You are Brahmins, and if I first make you into Brahmins from Shudra, then I make you into deities from Brahmins. This present birth of yours is your most valuable one. Even though there is the suffering of karma, the Father says, now consider yourselves to be souls and continue to remember me, the Father. Your sins can only be absolved when you practice this. Your sins can't be absolved by considering yourself to be a bodily being. Souls are not Brahmins. It is only when they have the bodies that they become Brahmins, then deities, and finally Shudra, etc. So it takes effort to remember the Father, and this is also called easy yoga. On one hand, Baba is saying it takes effort to remember the Father. On the other hand, Baba says this is also called easy yoga because, like many times Baba has reminded we children, that in case if you have love with the Father, then you would not experience the sense of effort. If there is mohabbat, in English we call it love, so there is no sense of mehnat, that is effort. So it is only when you have bodies that they become Brahmins. And so Baba says this yoga is very easy, and some of you experience it to be very difficult. You repeatedly forget the Father by becoming body conscious. It takes time to become soul conscious, and it's not yet possible for you to become constantly stable in remembrance of the Father. No, if you reach your karmatit stage, you cannot remain in your present body. And when your souls become completely pure, you become light and you instantly leave your bodies. A pure soul cannot remain in an impure body, and it is not that this Dada has gone across. He also says great effort is needed for remembrance. It is by becoming body conscious that you continue to fight and quarrel and say wrong things. Well, even on 18 January 1969, when Brahma Baba was about to leave his body and become Avyat, even at that time, even in his last Murli, he said that, I still have not become complete. I still need to practice a lot in order to become complete, equivalent to a deity. So basically, he was in an absolute egoless state. Because the moment we think that we are full, we are complete, there is no deformity in us. So that is the point from where you continue to fall down. That is body consciousness. So Baba says that he also says, this is the greatness of Brahma Baba, that he also says great effort is needed for remembrance. And it is by becoming body conscious that you continue to fight and quarrel and say wrong words. We souls are all brothers, and so nothing can then happen to souls. Baba says that it is only of body consciousness that there is confusion. You children now have to become soul conscious, just as deities live together like milk and sugar. So you too have to live with one another like milk and sugar. Never become like salt water. Body conscious human beings say wrong things and continue to fight. Baba says the body conscious human beings, they continue to fight with each other. Why? Because they are absolutely body conscious. So Baba says that you have to reach your karmatit stage, and you understand that your body and this world are old and tamopradhan. You should have disinterest in old things and old relationships. Renounce all aspects of body consciousness and consider yourselves to be souls and remember the Father and your sins will be absolved. Many children fail in remembrance and they become very clever at explaining knowledge, but they do need to make a great deal of effort to have remembrance. This is an important examination. Only those who have been devotees for half the cycle can understand these aspects. Those who actually came onto the path of devotion later will not understand as much. The Father enters this body and says, I come every 5,000 years. I only come once to play my part in the drama. And this 5,000 years, maybe in case if you need to convey this information further in future. So we must have this understanding that even science supports the time period of magnetic field to be approximately 5,000 years. And the record for universal flood is also 5,000 years. So basically, we all are in this world cycle of 5,000 years. So there is no rocket science. Well, Baba says this is the same confluence age. And the war is standing ahead. This drama is one of 5,000 years. And what would happen if 40,000 years of the cycle still remained? Just imagine if 40,000 years more on this very earth, in this particular condition, with impure air, impure water, with absolute devilish traits and etc. Well, anyway, Baba says, they say that even if God comes, they will not renounce the path of scriptures. They don't even know which God will come after 40,000 years. Some believe that God Krishna will come. As you go further, your name will be glorified. And however, you also have to have that stage. You have to live with one another with love. You're God's children. You are remembered as God's helpers. And you say that we are Baba's helpers to make impure Bharat pure. Baba, we become soul conscious every cycle by following your Srimad. And we have our sins absolved with the power of yoga. The power of yoga is the power of silence, and there is the difference of day and night, Baba says, between the power of silence and the power of science. Well, as you make progress, you will receive many visions, and many children had visions in the beginning and they played those parts. Today, they are no longer here and Maya ate them. When you do not stay in yoga, Maya eats you. Since your children know that God is teaching you, you should study with discipline. Maya ate you basically means that you were trapped in your old sanskar. Well, otherwise you will claim a very low status and also experience a lot of punishment. They saying, I have been sinful for many births and the kingdom of Ravan does not exist in the golden age. Therefore, how could there be any mention of vice? That is completely viceless kingdom. That is the kingdom of Ram and this is the kingdom of Ravan. And everyone at this time is Tamopradhan. Everyone of you children should examine your stage. Ask yourself, how long do I stay in remembrance of the Father? To what extent have I imbibed divine virtues? The main thing is to examine yourself to see that you don't have any defects in you. What are my food and drink like? Do I talk about useless things? Do I lie unnecessarily during the day? You sometimes have to lie for the livelihood of your body. Underline. When human actions, Baba says, when human beings make a donation, they believe that their sins will be absolved. When someone performs good actions, he receives the return of those. When someone opens a hospital, he will receive good health in his next birth. And if someone builds a college, he will be able to study well. But how could he attain? For basically, Baba is saying, how could he atone for his sins? That means maybe the individual is giving donations, but there is no point of his sins getting absolved. For that, they go and bathe in Gangas. And when someone gives a donation of money, he does receive the return of that in his next birth. But there is no question of his sins being absorbed by that. Baba says that is simply the give and take of wealth. That's it. If it was given in the name of God, then God gave a temporary reward for that. And here you have to become pure. There is no method for you to become pure other than having remembrance of the Father. Baba says pure ones, that is the souls who are pure. The pure ones cannot remain in the impure world. And people give donations indirectly in the name of God. And God says, I have now come personally to make you pure. I am the bestower. I give you the return of what you give me. I do not keep anything for myself. These buildings, etc. are built for you children. And sannyasi build big palaces, etc. for themselves. Here, Shiv Baba doesn't build anything for himself. He says, Because your give and take is direct, I give you the return of it in the new world for 21 births. Whatever money you give is used for you. I am the bestower on the path of devotion, and I am also the bestower now. That is indirect, whereas this is direct. And Baba says, whatever money you have, use it to open a center and benefit others. I also open centers, and it is you children who give, and it is you children I help. I do not bring money with me. I come and enter this one's body, and it is through him that I get my task done. I am going, Baba says, I am not going to the heaven. All of this is for you children. I am abhokta, that is free from experiencing anything. Neither do I take anything, nor do I say that fall at my feet. I am the most obedient servant of you children. See the egoless state of God. Well, Baba says, you also understand that he is your mother, your father, your everything. He's incorporeal, and you would never say of a guru that he's your mother, father, and everything. A guru is called a guru and a teacher, and that's it. Whereas you call that one the mother and father. The father says, I come once in every cycle. You celebrate Shiv Jayanti every 12 months. But when did Shiv Baba come and what did he do? And when he came, nobody knows about that. They don't even know the occupations of Brahma, Vishnu and Shankar because they have removed Shiv Baba from the top of that image. Shiv Baba is Karan Karavan Har. He acts through Brahma. You children also know how Baba enters this one's body and shows you what to do in a practical way. He himself tells this one that you must also do it like this. First study well, remember the father, imbibe divine virtues. Just as that one speaks, so this one says that I also remember Baba. It is as though Baba is with me. It is now in your intellect that you're going to become the masters of the new world. Therefore, your behavior as well as your food and drink shouldn't change. You have to renounce the vices. You have to reform yourselves. Each of you will take birth in an elevated family when you leave your body according to how much you reform yourself. And families are also number wise. Here too, some belong to very good families. 4 to 5 brothers, they live together and they don't even fight or quarrel. So you children now understand that you are going to the land of immortality where death cannot eat you and there is no question of fear. But here fear continues to grow day by day and you will not be able to go out. You also know that scarcely a few will study this knowledge and some can understand it very well even. And Baba says, and even right that it is very good. Such children will also definitely come. A kingdom has to be established. Very little time remains. And the father gives a lot of praise to the effort-making children who race ahead on the pilgrimage of remembrance. The main aspect is remembrance, and it is by having this remembrance that all of your old accounts are settled. Some children write to Baba and say, Baba, I sit in remembrance for this many hours every day. Then Baba thinks that that one is a great effort maker. You do not have to make effort. You do have to make effort, and this is why the father says, do not fight or quarrel with each other. He says, that is what animals do. To fight and quarrel is basically body consciousness. You defame the father's name through that, and it is of the father that it is said that anyone who defames the Satguru cannot reach the destination. However, the sadhus have applied that to themselves. Women are afraid of them in case they are cursed by them, and you now understand that you're changing from human beings into deities. You're listening to the true story of immortality, and you say, we come to the study palace in order to claim the status of Sri Lakshmi and Sri Narayan. This is not said anywhere else. We now have to return home, and the main effort needed for this is remembrance. You have had no remembrance for half a cycle. You now have to have remembrance in this one birth. This is the effort you children make, and you have to have remembrance and imbibe divine virtues. However, there is 100-fold punishment for any sinful acts you perform. You have to make effort and make yourself progress. It is the soul that studies through the body and becomes a barrister or a surgeon. The status of Lakshmi and Narayan is very elevated. Later on, those who hold the discourse of self-realization, Baba says, will receive many visions. You heard this knowledge a cycle ago too, and you are once again listening to this knowledge, and you came claim a status by listening. Later, this knowledge will disappear, and all of those scriptures belong to the path of devotion. Acha. To the sweetest beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bap Dada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children, and we spiritual children say namaste to the spiritual father. Well, essence for dharana is Examine yourself and ask, how long do I stay in remembrance of the Father? To what extent have I imbibed divine virtues, and are there any defects in me? Are my food, drink, activity and behavior royal? Do I talk about useless things? Do I tell lies? And Baba says, in order to increase your chart of remembrance, practice considering yourselves to be souls, brothers. Stay away from body consciousness. Baba is not asking to stay away from people. He says, stay away from body consciousness by keeping a good company, of course. Make time to make your stage constant and stable. Blessing is, may you have the blessing of the same applies to you by bringing time close with your stage of being equal to the Father. Basically, Baba is telling that to finish any consciousness of I means to remain stable in a stage equal to that of Father and to bring time close. When you feel some ownership of your body or any possession, there is a percentage in equality, and a percentage means a defect. Those with such defects can never become perfect. In order to become perfect, constantly remain merged in love for the Father. And by constantly remaining merged in love, you will easily be able to make others equal to yourselves and equal to the Father. Bab Dada gives his lovely children who gives his, Baba says, Bab Dada gives his lovely children who remain merged in love the blessing of the same applies to you. And slogan is, give regard to one another's ideas and your record will become good. Om Shanti.